In today's video, we're going to be leveraging Semrush's Keyword Magic Tool and pair it with ChatGPT to come up with different ideas for opportunities to get more organic traffic through the creation of calculators. ChatGPT can be a great way to create calculators that historically would have taken some developers to build, and now you can do it all without knowing a single line of code. Hopefully from today's video, you'll also be inspired to think about different ways that you might be able to use ChatGPT along with Semrush to make really cool things. So the first thing that I start with is I go into the Keyword Magic Tool, and I've typed in calculator. And the main reason why is because I want to focus on some really niche calculators that people might not really be focusing their time on. So one of the things I like to do is I like to look for lower keyword difficulties. I'm going to go by 0 to 40 here. And then what I'm also going to do is I'm going to go ahead and add in this extra filter, word count of 3 or more. And the other thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to make sure that we're looking somewhere in the range of a couple hundred, but not too many monthly searches. So here I'm going to do 200 to maybe 2,500. And the reason why I'm doing this is because I'm starting from a base of thousands of keywords, and I just want to pare this down a little bit more. And so here what you can see is you can see a variety of different long tail keywords that are already coming back: cardiac output calculator, cash on cash return calculator. So these are interesting, right? But the other thing I like to do is I like to go through and I like to look at how many results are coming back and what's the competitive density score. And the reason why is because this will just tell you, as Semrush is explaining, it's the amount of competition that an advertising competitor is actually bidding here. And also the number of results tells you how many URLs are getting returned for the sort of query. The reason why that's helpful is because if it's a really high number, like it's in the hundreds of millions, like you can see with the Ability Stone calculator, it probably means that there's a lot of different calculators that already exist for that. Whereas what we really want is we want only for there to be a couple different calculators in order for us to feel like there's an opportunity. So here you can see, right, like in this case, adding and subtracting polynomials calculator is actually keyword difficulty 31, 2400 monthly volume, and yet there's only a few results in terms of what Semrush is estimating here. So if I were to just literally, you know, right click that and take a look here, you can see that there's a couple calculators here. And just in general though, the number of results is 379,000, as opposed to if I were to search that keyword calculator or the Ability Stone calculator rather, what I can see is you can see the 170 million search results. So just something to keep in mind is, as much as possible, try not to look for things that have way too many search results, because it's just generally a losing game for you. All right, so that's the first tip I can give you when it comes to calculators. One of the best things you can do when you're creating calculators is making sure that you're not creating a calculator in a space where there's a ton of other calculators. So in this particular case, when I see something like Ability Stone calculator and I see it's getting 178 million search results, that's scary to me because it means that there's a ton of different URLs that are getting crawled for that long tail phrase, compared to the adding and subtracting polynomials calculator, where technically there's only 60 or so. I don't actually believe that, but at the same time, I also can validate this. And the way I can do that is I can just simply search and then go ahead. And here you can see 379,000 results for this particular case. And the other thing is you can go ahead and take a look at the Ability Stone calculator. Here you can see that there's 170 million results. All right, there are some interesting things in here though. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and refine even further. I'm gonna take it down to keyword difficulty of 20% instead of 40, so cut it in half. That's gonna cut my keyword returns by about, you know, an eighth, so that's awesome. And now what I can do is I can really start to zero in on some of these phrases. So it looks like there's an engraving calculator, lost arc, color calculator for horses. I have no idea what that is. I'm gonna actually go ahead and search that because I'm intrigued. Color. That's hilarious. Okay, so apparently this is a thing. It's essentially going through and giving you offspring probabilities. That's pretty cool, actually. All right, so from Semrush, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and do a quick export from here. What I've done is I've just gone ahead and trimmed this list down a little bit more. And what I had was I had an Excel sheet, which I then am going to paste into ChatGPT. I'm running up on my GPT-4 cap for the last few hours, and so I'm gonna use GPT-3.5. Shouldn't make that big of a difference in terms of the analysis for this sort of work. But here I can say, act like an Excel analyst and also an SEO wizard with decades of experience. You're given this data set. You're tasked with create a table identifying the 10 best opportunities. Please consider keyword difficulty. Please also factor in a scale of 1 to 5. output your results in a table, just to make sure it's clear. All right, so here we go. Some ideas here: Ability Stone Calculator, AP Psych Score Calculator, Bowl Score Calculator, that's interesting, Evolution Calculator for Pokemon, Honing Calculator Lost Ark, Horse Color Calculator, Lost Ark Ability Stone Calculator, OSRS Dry Calculator, and AP Physics Score Calculator, AP Stats Score Calculator. So there might be some interesting things in the testing phase space for this sort of stuff. But just in general, what you can see is these are some of the opportunities. And so here's an example where now I have this idea, Bowl Score Calculator. And now you can see, like, what does your competition look like? So you can see that this is a site called bowlinggenius.com. Another one's called Sports Calculators. Another one's called Easy Calculation. And now you can kind of see how it's a very simple website, see what you're up against. It's pretty simple stuff. Looks like these sites pretty much are probably monetized by ads. If I disable this, you can probably see all the ads. Yeah, they're all over the place. So that's how these folks are making money. And yeah, these are all kind of ugly websites, right? But what's really cool about this is that what I did was, if I wasn't good at synthesizing things, coming up with ideas, or analyzing data, I can just feed that into ChatGPT and have it analyze some of that for me. So here you can see Bowl Score Calculator is coming up. It's getting 2,400 monthly visits, 16 keyword difficulty. That's potentially interesting to me. And so what I can do from here is I can actually create a new thing here and say, now act like an experienced web developer. You need to create a bowl score calculator. How would you consider doing so? As simply as possible. All right, so now you can see, all right, as an experienced developer, here's what I need: HTML, CSS, JavaScript, input, score validation, event handling, responsive design, testing, and deployment. All right, can you take a first stab at writing the HTML structure, the HTML for calculating a bowl score? Think you may, let's just go ahead and see what it returns. Boom. All right, great. It looks like I need some JavaScript. What logic would you propose for calculating a bowling score? All right, so now you can start to see I'm starting to work through this. All right, so as I start to work through this, what I'm thinking about is, what are all these different component parts? How do I sort of structure this page? And then from here, come up with something that's kind of similar to what some of these folks are doing. Because ultimately what all these are built on is just some basic code. And what's happening from here is this just having some inputs, and it's changing the input based off of that for what the score is. Okay, so this is something that's really cool, because back in the old days, you used to actually have to hire a developer in order to complete this. Whereas if you really wanted to explore this with ChatGPT, what you'd be able to do is you'd be able to continue working with GPT to essentially create this for you, and then you could deploy this code onto your site, and from there you would have a working calculator, and you could do this over and over again. So when you look at these sites like sportcalculators.com, it goes and shows you that you can pretty much build a site for anything, and if there's long tail traffic around it, then it might be worth it to do so. All these perspective opportunities here on this site are very simple. They're just clear, simple inputs, and then they're just repurposing as much as possible as they can when it comes to the different types of calculators they're creating. And what's really cool here is that if you go ahead and look up sportcalculators.com, you can see how over the years, it's been a site that's been as old as 2014. So it's been almost a decade that the site has been around. It's got an authority score of 24. It's getting thousands of monthly visits, and it's pretty much just calculators. In this particular case, they decided to group everything together in sport, but pretty much what you can see here is they just have, you know, bowl score calculator, which is that long tail phrase, pace bike calculator, bike pace calculator, and all this jazz that you could essentially create as well. So this is just validation for you that this can work for you and you can monetize it. So ultimately it's pretty simple and straightforward, but what's really cool about this is that when you remember back on my keyword magic tool, they were literally just from the filter of 200 to 2500 monthly volume and keyword difficulty of less than 20%, there was over 1400 ideas for you right here. And so there's a niche somewhere for you. And all you need to do is just parse through this sort of data to find those sorts of opportunities. In the case where you want to try this out for yourself, feel free to check out Semrush. If you don't already have an account, you can check out my link in the video description below to start your free trial. And in the case where you end up building something, feel free to let me know how it goes. I'm excited for you, and best of luck in your website building journey.